five, six, seven, eight.
Welcome to 5678, a show about dance. Now today, we're going to be focused on the style of tap. I actually started doing tap dance at the age of 7, and I did it until 5 years ago when I discovered ballroom. Now the thing about tap is it's very, very rhythmic, and the focus of this show is going to be showing you that tap can be done at all ages, from very young to very old. I'm here with Dottie, who is the instructor of all of the tap performers that we're about to see today. Now, Dottie, how long have you been tap dancing?
Oh, I've been tap dancing since I was 4.
Wow.
And I'm 67 now, so that's a little while.
Now, tell us a little bit about how you got into it.
Well, when I was 4 years old, my mother decided that I needed to learn how to get along with other kids since I was an only child and I lived in a neighborhood with adults.
Oh.
And so she decided that I should go to dancing school. And so I went to tap dance class and I loved it.
So you went to New York to perform?
I did.
Oh, tell us about that.
I did 3 Broadway shows.
Great.
And I did a couple of national tours. And I was fortunate enough to dance with Ruby Keeler.
Wow.
In one of the shows. And I danced with Ann Miller in a show.
Fabulous.
Not on Broadway, but somewhere else, and a couple of other tappers. So I was fortunate enough to see the real deal, should we say.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
So when did you get into teaching then?
Well, I actually got into teaching before I went to New York. I assisted my teacher. I think I started probably at 13, and so I was able to teach for a while, and that helped me being in the Broadway companies and the road companies because I became dance captain and then I became the teacher of all of the replacements for the shows.
Now, in terms of tap in your future, are you going to keep tapping?
Oh, I'm going to keep tapping. I have some students that are well into their 80s and 90s and I think if they can do it, I can do it. I love to dance, first of all, just like you.
Thank you.
And but there's something about tap, you're just not a dancer, you're also a musician. And you are playing the floor as if it were a drum. You're being the drummer of your piece that you are performing.
And why do you think tap is great for all ages? Because we're gonna see dancers of all ages on this show.
Well, for the kids, it helps with their coordination. It helps with their discipline. Learning the patterns of dance and having to memorize that thing, those things help with reading and with math, of course, because you are a percussionist, and it teaches them to listen and to take direction, which they're going to need all the rest of their lives. And as we get older, for some of my students that are in their 60s and beyond, we do it to help with balance, to help memory, and to be social with other people that enjoy it.
Yeah, I found one of those internet quotes once. It says, "You don't stop dancing because you're old.
Right.
You grow old because you stop dancing."
That's right.
I think
absolutely.
That's very appropriate here. Now, I understand that you have a time step number. Can you give us the background of that?
There are tons of time steps, and time steps is your basic tap step. And so I put together this number so that the kids and my adults would be able to see the difference in all of the time steps. So you'll see single, double, triple, traveling, whatever. And anyway, I hope you like it.
Now, I understand we're going to see a boy and a girl doing a little number for us.
We're going to see Jacob and Bryn, and they are my Fred and Ginger.
Wow.
So they will be doing the Fred Astaire medley.
Fantastic.
Yeah, here they go.
Fantastic job on your routine.
Thank you.
Now, how did you first discover tap?
I discovered it when I was 5 or 6, I think. My mom took me to the Stanford Theater to watch Gene Kelly and Singing in the Rain, and I thought it was photoshopped in. And when she told me it was real, I didn't get it. So I said I wanted to try that, and I've loved tap ever since.
What do you like best about tap?
I like that you can go free with it. Even though you do have a rhythm, you don't have to have a partner every single moment. You only need a pair of shoes to tap. You don't need all this stuff to tap.
So what were you for Halloween? I hear that that was a dance-themed costume.
I was Fred Astaire.
Wow.
My friend Giorgio and I, we went trick-or-treating. He was Buster Posey. I was Fred Astaire, and we went to the exact same houses. Because I did tap dance, I got 20% more candy. He got 80 pieces, I got 104.
Wow, so you actually did tap dancing as part of your trick-or-treating?
Yep.
That's fantastic. That sounds like a lot of fun.
It was.
Now, you're the only boy in your class, right?
Yeah.
How do you feel about that?
Well, at the beginning of class, when I very first started, I felt kind of embarrassed. But as it went on, I felt pretty good that I'm the only boy.
So do you get better roles, better positions?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah. That's really nice. What are you going to do with TAP in the future? Do you know?
I want to be a movie star on Broadway.
Wow. Well, then I'm going to have to come see you when you make it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, too.
I understand that next we're going to see three young ladies in a number.
Yes, they're from my advanced TAP class. And it's Lauren, Medina, and Sebrian, and they will be doing Get Happy.
Well, let's take a look.
Okay.
Awesome job on your routine.
Thank you so much.
How long have you been tap dancing?
I've been tap dancing for about 10 years now. I think I started when I was around 5 or 6.
Wow, that's a long time. Did you ever do any other kinds of dances?
I did ballet for a little bit, but I recently quit it because I've been busy doing other activities such as horseback riding.
Oh, wow. Now that's very different.
Yeah.
Does tap help you with your horseback riding at all?
Yeah, I think it does. It has a lot to do with rhythm and the movement. So I think the rhythm that I find in tap, you know, helps me with my horses.
I never thought about that. Yeah, it is very rhythmic. I definitely never thought about that. Now, how long did you take to rehearse for this particular number?
This particular number we did in my advanced tap class at the Menlo Park Dance Academy. Mm-hmm. And so I had rehearsed for it a while, and then I rehearsed for it a little bit with my partners, Sebrianna Medina.
So. Okay, great. So was it always just the three of you performing it?
No, it was basically our whole class performing it, so we did have to downsize some of the movements and the choreography and the configurations.
Okay. But I really liked the way it came out.
Thank you.
Now, what are your plans for TAP in the future?
I do. I am an assistant for Dottie at her studio with some of her classes, so I'm hoping to continue to be an assistant teacher, and I'd love to do some musical theater that involves tap dancing because I'm an avid singer. I love to perform, so. Oh.
Well, since you're also a singer, you'll get better roles, not just chorus. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Now that you've seen some numbers here in the studio, we thought you'd like to visit an actual dance studio. So we're going to go ahead and visit the adult tap class and talk to some of the dancers there.
I started in 2001 when I retired. I'm a longtime swing dancer, West Coast Swing. Swing and tap are fairly closely related, both the music, which is swing music, and also some of the basic idea of rhythm, which is important to swing, and of course, that's all tap is. I'm a trained pastry chef, sort of a sideline. So I usually bring in some of my toffee sometimes, and I like to make various kinds of confections, among other things.
Dancing in the same place. I've been at Park Academy of Dance for 42 years.
Now you were telling me that you did some shows where you tapped in community theater.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Well, I've done quite a few musicals in the community, and some of the tap shows were Anything Goes, Kiss Me Kate, Hello Dolly, and then as an actress and singer, Oklahoma, Sound of Music, My Fair Lady.
Oh, fantastic. Now, you were mentioning a one-woman show to me. Tell us about that.
Well, after I found it too hard to go and, to rehearsals and opening nights and all that, staying up till all hours, so I got a grant from the California Arts Council to perform a show called Broadway Ladies, to act out some of the parts that I knew about and that I took myself, and that would lead into a song and then do one tap dance to do it for senior citizens. But I ended up also doing it for private parties and a retirement party at Sunset Magazine, things like that.
About 5 years. It's really flown by. It doesn't seem that long. What led you to try it?
Well, I was doing a show, and Dottie, our teacher, was the choreographer. And there was just it wasn't really a tap show, but there was just a little bit where I wanted my character to shuffle off to Buffalo. And God love her, she tried to teach me how, and I just couldn't. I just couldn't tap. And the fact that I was so bad at it made me want to do it. So, you know, she said, well, I teach a tap class twice a week, and I started going, and I've been addicted ever since. This will be my 35th year.
Wow. Now, you were mentioning to me that you have a pacemaker.
Yes. 7 years ago, I was climbing pyramids in Cambodia, and I ended up with a virus that attacked the AV node of my heart. Long story dull, I ended up with a pacemaker, and my first question out of surgery was, I will be able to tap dance, won't I? And here we are 7 years later.
That's great. So it really helps with your health as well.
Oh, absolutely, yes.
Now, you were telling me you've done some musicals, too.
Oh, it's been a while ago now. I did some Dames at Sea, Babes at Arms, Little Abner, A Christmas Carol.
Okay, well, next time you do one, let me know. I want to watch.
Okay.
Dottie, you're going to be doing another number for us. I would really love to see more about this, hear more about this. You said it's a rhythm tap number.
It is rhythm tap, and rhythm tap is, it's closer to the floor. It has more intricate sounds. This one happens to be to more of an African beat, and it's really fun. I hope you like it.
I'm sure I will.
It's called Hot Percussion.
Take it away.